Hallo und willkommen zu einer neuen Ausgabe. Welcome to another exciting episode of Let's Talk Morok. My name is André Neumann. I say hi. And yeah, basically it's a new episode of a jam, some music, or at least some phrases I will do in the next couple of minutes. Maybe it will be 60 minutes, and let's see how it goes. So I've got a couple of instruments here. I again reorganized all my studio, my home studio equipment. So what I found in the last couple of jam sessions was that if I stand and don't sit, it's different. It's better. I think it's better if you don't sit on your ass while you jam. It's a total different view and a totally different approach if you're standing on your feet, and you have more control, you have more power and more presence, and I think that's key, and your instruments can feel that too, I guess. So let's see how inspiration goes today. Maybe some words about my setup today. I'll use the Octatrack again as my main heart, I guess. I would say it's both the brain, the heart, and everything comes together in this magic little black box from Electron. It's really cool. I'm getting better and better with it, but there's still so much to learn about this fantastic device. It's really not that easy to do. And I also got my lovely OP1 here. You can hear him in the back. And an Electron analog keys and a Nord stage. And of course my guitar with some effects too. All this goes through an iPad and then to the Electron box. And it's all connected through an iConnect MIDI device. That means there's everything, or almost everything, is in sync right now. I really had a hard time struggling to get all these devices working nice together. It's not that easy. So again, the Octatrack is the heart, so if I push play there, everything else is in sync at least. So there's a MIDI clock going from the Octatrack through everything, and it was really tough, but I found a way, and right now it's working pretty good. Right now I'm reading a book I can show you. Really cool. It's from Mr. Dennis DeSantis from Ableton, and it's called Making Music. It's not exactly about what would you call it? About notes or about rhythms or anything. It's more about approaches or techniques, tips and tricks, how to improve your songwriting, your way of making music. And one part is that you set up your equipment the way you like it. That means maybe if you stand, it's easier, it's better for you, or you try to reduce it. So there are a couple of pretty cool tips in there, and I really like it. I recommend it to you, and maybe you still search for some Christmas presents or so. I think it's pretty cool. Anyway, the best thing I think if you do music, or if you want to jam, is the best practice is if you actually do it. It's hard to start, but it's like if you jump into a bottle of cold water, just do it, and it will be refreshing and adventurous and tragedous at the same time. So it's pretty tough, but pretty cool. Okay, enough for the speech. I put the information about the setup in the show notes, so you can read through and maybe take a look if you want to inform you about anything else. You can also send me a message or drop me a line. I'm happy to help. So it's a community thing, and a lot of people helped me through the years on the internet, so I want to give something back to you, my friends. Again, my name is André Neumann, and the show is called Let's Talk Maroc, and that's what I should do right now, and play some music. So I started the octa track and listen to the lovely sound of a click and nothing else. You won't hear it because it's routed only to the headphones. What I wanted to try in the last couple of days and weeks, I'm experimenting with a more, how would I say, not a pattern-based workflow, so more a coincidence workflow. And the OP1 has a really cool sequencer in there. I don't know if you can see it, but it's called the, the Tombola, and it's really a Tombola, so it's really hard to tell how it's going on, but you have a little Tombola thing, and then you can turn it and you can put in notes, and then the thing does its magic, and it's unpredictable but pretty cool. So maybe I start this and feed this into the octa track and see if this works out good or not. Recorded the first loop, it's in the octa track, and the cool thing is it's not too repetitive. If you listen to music and you feel that it only consists of some patterns, it's getting boring, I think. So you can do a lot of things with loops, but I think it's cool if the loops don't have the same size or don't have the same length, so it differs through the song and it feels more natural. So I have this in the octa track, and let's see how I can deform it that it won't sound that way. I have assigned it to a new slot, and now it's working and I can mangle with it. In the beginning it's really hard to work with the octa track because you have to twist your head around the way it works and how it deals with different machines and static machines and flex machines, and they have advantages and disadvantages. But in the end, if you read the manual and ask the community at electronauts.com, it works out pretty cool. mouth drum here. Try to incorporate. Let's see how that works. Maybe again on the iPad, I work with VocaLive for all the vocal inputs, so it gets distracted on the recording. Recorded a little loop here and assign it to a new machine. Set an LFO to the pitch of this sample. Some guitar. I don't know if it works out. It sounds pretty crazy so far. Sometimes this happens. It's not a problem, but it can be really tough to play a melody to this kind of stuff. Let's see how it works. Thank you. left another loop with the guitar. Maybe the start thing we recorded in the first place, maybe it's also for an intro. I often like an introduction to a song, and then you can start off with a melody that's totally different. Sometimes it works out, sometimes not. So let's see how it goes. Saving the samples and assigning to a new slot. Guitar loop is recorded. Let's see how that works out. I work without a click right now. It's pretty cool. It's pretty new to me, so I don't know how it worked. So basically, you don't know when you start to record and when you're finished recording. But that's what I meant when I said that if the loops are from different length, they overwhelm each other and they don't move in the same way. This is an e-bow, and with this I can perform string-like things on the guitar. Basically, it's just a magnetic thing, and you put it on your strings, and then they run forever. the loop with the Evo. Let's assign it again. You see, it's always the same. On the radio, this is Let's Talk Morocco. It's a radio show basically that's also recorded on video, so you can follow along how I do it and maybe get some inspiration. If you start out or want to make your own songs, you can watch the video and listen to the stupid things I say and maybe can do something on your own. So if you want to, you can check out the website. There's a link to the video and you can watch it there. Mm-hmm. nothing in the file. That sucks. There is something in the file, but it's not playing back. Oh, it's muted, I guess. I'm stupid. The light is too high, so I can't see the lights. Now it's working. Cool. Maybe add some panorama. That's enough for the guitar for me right now, so let's see if I can put in some more synth goodness. Thank you. the playback of some tracks so they get reversed. From the analog keys, has a pretty cool joystick, so you can do pretty extensive modification. The only thing that sucks, you can't record it on the actual machine, so if we record a pattern there, it won't get recorded. It's a little drawback, but if we record it directly to the Octatrack, it's no problem.
Thank you.
cool thing on the Octatrack is you can work with scenes. So basically this is the first scene, and then you can have another scene and can apply some really weird stuff to the scene. So I'll try this next. It's always a little bit of coincidence and good luck and bad luck, and it's no problem because you can always erase the scene and can go back to normal, and then you still have your first scene. So it's just a sort of trial and error songwriting approach. So cool to pitch things down and listen how it sounds. It's like if you slow the time, and it's like watching slow motion on television, and you see and you hear things that are actually there that you can't hear in real time. It's so cool. Mix between the scenes and find a good spot. I like this the most, I'm sorry. Try to find something on the piano for it. Thank you. good take. I hope it recorded well. Spooky if you have a good take and have to save the sample and your hands get wet, and it's really a big moment. On this machine I revert back to all the standard settings. So all the other tracks are pitched down and really atmospheric, big and deep, and then you have this piano on top. Maybe it works out good. At the end, as always. Don't know if it works out. Maybe this is an instrumental track, but I just want to give it a try. Thank you. das nicht so cool. Ich glaube, das ist ein Instrumental-Track. Die Zeit ist jetzt auch abgelaufen. Switched to German just one second ago. I'm sorry. I'm stupid, but it's so many knobs. Thank you so much for listening. That was Let's Talk Morocco. My name is André Neumann, and hope to see you next time, to hear you next time. Please leave a message, share the video and talk about it, and hopefully you find some inspiration and grab your guitar or whatever you have and start recording your own songs. You can do it. Thanks.